one of the most commonly used finish drags is a steel mat drag like you see here. Now the steel mat drag can do quite a few things. First of all, in soils where you get a lot of chunking, this steel mat drag, because of the action and the friction that occurs as the soil moves through this drag, helps to break up those chunks real easily. Now, on the downside of this drag is that because it can take up this soil and pulverize it and move it around, it tends to load up on soil. So this kind of drag mat typically transports a lot of material. When you start out dragging, it loads up and it pulls material away. So as an operator, you have to be conscientious that wherever you start a drag on the infield with a steel mat drag, you have to finish it, because you've taken material away, you've got to put it back at the end. These drags are great for any type of infield soil, whether it's a top dress infield or not, but especially crucial for an infield that does not have a top dressing, because you need this type of a drag to break up soil chunks. Ahead of the steel mat here is what's called a leveling bar. Now, the leveling bar does exactly what it says it does. It levels material out ahead of it. What it actually does is do the brunt of the work ahead of the drag. So if you hit an area up out ahead of this where you have a lot of loose material, say right around second base where sliding has caused a pileup of material on the other side of the bag, the leveling bar grabs the majority of that material and spreads it out along the width of this drag bar before the drag comes to it. So the drag doesn't have to do so much of the dirty work. The drag basically is just going out and finish smoothing it off. It's the drag bar that takes the bulk of that loose material and spreads it out for it. This is really a crucial piece of equipment, especially when you're using a cocoa mat drag.